Hello friends, welcome to Easy Academy. In this lecture, let us understand a problem on block diagram reduction. They have given a block diagram and we need to reduce the block diagram and we need to find the transfer function C of S divided by R of S. In this block diagram, if you observe, these two blocks are in parallel. So first we can reduce these two blocks and we can simplify the block diagram. We have simplified these two blocks and we have written it as a single block, and the transfer function we have written it as G2 minus G3. The remaining portion of the block diagram remains as it is. Now in this block diagram, we can see these two blocks are in series and this summing point let us shift after the block H2. Now these two blocks are simplified and we have written it as a single block and we have taken the transfer function as G1 into G2 minus G3 since these two blocks are in series. Now we have shifted this summing point after the block H2, and in the summing point we have written one more transfer function which is H2. This is the rule we need to follow. When you shift the summing point after a block, you need to write the same block in the path of the summing point. So along with G4 we have written H2, which was not present in this previous block diagram. Now this is very important here. Now we need to combine these two summing blocks and make it as a single summing block. So if you observe, this summing block is having one input, this summing block is having two inputs. If we combine these two summing blocks, we will get a single summing block with three inputs. Input will be R of S and this input and input from this point. Let us combine this summing point. Along with that, these two blocks are in series and these two blocks are in series. Let us simplify these two along with combining the summing points and let us write the block diagram. After simplifying this, we got a summing point with three inputs. You can see first input is from R of S, the second input is from the feedback path of R of S, and third input is from the feedback path of C of S. Now we have written different polarities here. Now this is very important how to write these polarities. Now plus sign here we have written as it is because we had plus sign here. Now we have written a plus sign here, but in the feedback loop we had a negative sign. So what we need to do, this negative sign and already existing negative sign here, we need to multiply as we move in the signaling path. So minus sign here, it is multiplied with this minus sign, it will become plus sign. And in this path, it is plus sign. As we move in this path, so plus sign multiplied with minus sign, we'll write it as a negative sign. So this is very important while combining the summing points. In this simplified block, if you see along the forward path, we don't have any block here. So what we need to do, we need to take G is equal to 1. So if you take G is equal to 1, these two will act as parallel block. So that's why we need to apply parallel formula while simplifying these two blocks. And here we can use the transfer function of simplified closed loop system with negative feedback. So we know for negative feedback, the transfer function is G divided by 1 plus GH. After simplifying these two blocks, we have written it as 1 plus G4H2. And these two blocks are simplified and written it as G1, G2. We have multiplied this minus G1, G3 divided by 1 plus G1, G2 minus G1, G3 into H1, H2. Now, since these two blocks are in series now, we can write the transfer function as 1 plus G4H2 multiplied with G1, G2 minus G1, G3 whole divided by 1 plus G1, G2 minus G1, G3 into H1, H2. This is nothing but C of S divided by R of S. So this is the overall transfer function of the given block diagram. Hope you have understood this topic. Thank you.